In order to use the HDMI connector on your TrueTrainer, it's really quite simple. You have to connect an HDMI cable to the socket, and it needs to be connected to a monitor that is preferably turned on. So only then, and that's important, you have to do this before turning on the trainer, because it detects whether a monitor is connected and only then puts out a signal on the HDMI port in order to save energy. So now we're turning on the trainer, and you will see the startup sequence on the screen. And as you can see from the blinking lights, the startup is still in sequence, but there's a lot of initialization that has to be done. And the screen next to the LEDs also tells you which part of the initialization sequence we're in. So now we're all set up. We're logged in. And as you can see, we're logged in as the guest user. And we're ready to start using the trainer. But I don't want to log in as guest. I want to log in as myself. So what I do is I go to the app, connect to the trainer. And when I connect, the trainer knows that it's now me, so it knows my weight, it knows the gears I need, and you see that the gears change, my name changes, and with this, you're good to go. So when we start cycling, you see that the speed increases accordingly. So there's a number of things that we show you. We show you the virtual gear that you're in. If you want to know about virtual gearing, see our video about that. It gives you a graph of your power, it gives you a graph of your heart rate. If you want to know how to connect a heart rate monitor, see our video about that. It also gives you your heart rate number, your 10-second power average, the energy you've expended, the cadence, and the speed.